When you say the word RPG in a crowd, you're effectively starting a countdown to when someone brings up Fallout, at least one of the games in the series. It's a beloved franchise, fondly remembered for having a complex world full of engaging encounters, with multiple developers taking on different games for over 20 years since the first game's release. People have a lot of thoughts and opinions about the series. But with all of the hype, nostalgia, and the fear of the less-than-criticism-friendly fans of the Fallout franchise have interacted with over the years, touching on something as sacred as Fallout is pretty nerve-wracking. But as someone who's never played the original games, no amount of surface knowledge or stories from fans prepared me for one unavoidable truth that everyone I talked to failed to mention. Fallout plays like ass. Fallout is more than its user interface, but the player will constantly have to deal with it. And that's a hard sell, because Fallout has the worst control scheme and user interface I've personally ever used. In games, in software, just used, period. Even when handing out benefits with every doubt on design choices and layout, God, it's still terrible user interface. So in order to explain why Fallout is so hard to actually play, I need to dig into this a little bit deeper. For example, the display in the lower left conveys critical information, like if your weapon breaks during a fight, or if you've been exposed to radiation. It also displays information on basically everything you hover your mouse over, including walls, objects, and yourself. Since the screen is so small, and because of how rapidly information floods it, useful or even critical information can fly by the screen without noticing it. And while you can see information that your screen previously displayed, it's still buried, and you'd have to know that something critical passed you and you didn't see it in order to go back to look for it. Your inventory is a single vertical list that cannot be rearranged or organized. You have a maximum amount of weight you can carry, and each item weighs a certain amount. Simple enough on the surface, but the problems start when you actually have to do anything in your inventory. Clicking on an item in your inventory doesn't show you much information. If you want to know something critical, like, you know, how much damage a weapon does, a mildly important stat for a weapon, you have to equip the weapon, and then it'll tell you. And if you want to know how many action points using a weapon takes, which is as important as the damage it does, you have to equip it, then leave your inventory, and then look at it on the main screen. You can only see your total carrying capacity in one menu, but you can't see how much total weight your equipment takes up in that menu. You have to go to a different menu. And you can't see either of those stats when you're looting bodies or purchasing equipment, requiring you to leave the interaction menu you're in and then check those other two menus to find out the information. And then go back to the body you're looting or the person you're talking to or... Ugh. This kind of layered disaster of user-unfriendly design is littered basically throughout the entire interface. This makes even the simplest actions just incredibly tedious. And I think I spent more total time fiddling with the menus than anything else. And it's not just within the menus that Fallout is consistently inconsistent. Oh, do you want to leave this menu? Escape works, for certain menus. Other times you have to push an on-screen button. Oh, you want to use an item on the environment. Well, sometimes you have to click on the environment, hold down right-click, drag the selector to the Use Item icon, then select the item from your inventory. Other times you have to equip the item, and then use it on the object. And sometimes you have to do two different things even for the same action, like tying a rope around something to climb into a pit.
I could use either method getting into one pit, but for another pit the first method didn't work and I had to use the second method.
While the Cinnabite-designed labyrinth of menus is torturous,
we have such sights to show you.
I give some credit for it playing into a key feature of the game. Fallout is purposefully brutal. It will gleefully kill you or softlock you without hesitation. And that was definitely a source of frustration when coupled with the unclear quests and inconsistent interactions. I don't hold that level of challenge against it. I like that one mistake on my part could mean the end, and I have to restart from a previous save. The wasteland is supposed to be harsh. There was always something out there that was faster than me, or with more firepower, or has greater numbers. No matter how well equipped I was never truly free from consequences. The problem I do have with all of that is Fallout doesn't make any of that fun. Combat often also lacks enjoyment. You have a set number of action points that you can use to do things like enter your inventory to use items, such as stem packs to heal, fire your weapon, or move. And there's strategy involved with prioritizing targets, using action points to move out of their range to make enemies lose their action points to get within range of you, and using VATs to target specific body parts. The problem is, enemies are simplistic and predictable. So after you learn a few strategies from different types of enemies, you know what to do in basically every situation. This is made worse by the player's power creep. After struggling for so long just to defeat a few rats without dying, the combination of leveling my skills and the equipment I found hit a threshold that obliterated the difficulty, making nearly every encounter kinda trivial. The ability to change the difficulty whenever helps to regain some of the challenge, but reintroducing challenge means just falling back on those few strategies I learned earlier. Combat lacks complexity, variety, satisfaction, or nuance required to make that kind of gameplay fun for me. But when people tell me Fallout is the greatest game of all time, no one tells me it was for the gameplay. They tell me it's because of the world building, story, and memorable characters.
And the world of Fallout has a lot of interesting dynamics.
No group is really pure protagonist material. Everyone from Vault Dwellers to Raiders to the Brotherhood of Steel have problems, making it easy to judge every group or person you come across. However, the Wastes are a brutal place, and you can quickly find yourself on the wrong side of a power fist if you say the wrong thing or open the wrong door. You also need to rely on people that you don't like in order to survive. The drug dealer who threatened you is the only person you've met with Radex, and you need that to keep from dying from radiation poisoning. So, you make a deal with them. The Brotherhood of Steel has the armor you need to stay alive, so you reluctantly help them out. That creates some interesting dynamics and intriguing interactions. Unfortunately, that complexity of interactions is mostly relegated to the player's imagination. You can go stomping up to a Child of the Atom cultist in full power armor signed by every left-handed member of the Brotherhood of Steel, and they'll treat you the same as if you wore a three-piece suit or assless chaps. And if it was just an average RPG, that wouldn't be a problem. But with the emphasis on the story and the visuals that specifically tell you who is who based on things like their armor, it feels completely out of place. This disregard for your choices furthers the feeling that weapons, armor, and even your reputation are just numbers, and you're always incentivized to just do whatever gives you the biggest numbers because the rest doesn't really matter. As for the memorable characters, having to brave the brutal wastes and interact with folks in the isolated cities is mostly a slog. You could talk to dozens of people who have dialogue that don't say anything interesting or unique or tell you something that aids in the world building or your quest. The few interactions that are genuinely engaging require dozens of pointless conversations with other people until you find one person who actually has something useful to say. And hopefully when you do find them, you're actually paying attention and your eyes haven't glazed over from all the stagnant dialogue that came before it. Because of how many dull, uneventful things happen between moments of intrigue, I will say it did make those moments of intrigue incredibly memorable, and the few characters that have voice acting are also enjoyable. But I only remember a few unique characters throughout my playthrough, and most of them were memorable because their opening dialogue wasn't them being rude.
The main story holds up thanks to its simplicity and how well it connects to different people and groups and themes throughout the entire game.
It has a great sense of affecting the entire area and every person in it, and it ties in elements you discover from all over the wastes to give completing it some weight. But most of the time, what I did didn't feel like it mattered. If it sounds like I'm just complaining and haven't told you what the actual gameplay is like, that's part of the problem. That is the gameplay. You mostly do five things. You wander, usually with only a vague idea of where you're supposed to go or what you're trying to find. You interact with every area in hopes to find one person who can give you a sense of where to go. You fight, you click on objects in the environment to see if they do anything, and you struggle with the user interface. And you do that last one during and between every other step until you get used to the user interface. And then you continue to struggle with it because even when working properly, it's still bad. When I had a quest and I knew what to do, I was having fun. When I knew where to go or why I was fighting someone, the tedium vanished behind the sense of purpose. But I'm not exaggerating when I say that in 23 to 25 hours of play across a few characters, I enjoyed about 3 hours of my time. And then there are the glitches. I don't expect devs to fix every problem in a, let me calculate this, 23-year-old game, but they are something modern players are going to have to deal with. So I wanted to go over the major ones that I had throughout my playtime. If you launch the game and tab out, Fallout continues to run but becomes inaccessible. You can make tabbing out possible if you run it in windowed mode, but then you can't change the aspect ratio. The game crashed on me around 8 times, about half of those happening during the final boss fight. Items on the ground could become inaccessible if something like a corpse covered them, and saddest of all, my companion just vanished while I was walking through the city, never to be seen or heard from again. After defeating the final boss, in my adrenaline-fueled dash to escape, surrounded by enemies, trying to get one cultist out of the doggone elevator so I could escape, the game crashed. And it corrupted my save file. So while I could have reloaded an older save file and fought him again, it wasn't worth it. I beat the boss, and I didn't care enough about the story anymore to see what the final cutscene told me.
So,
I think you know at least part of the answer to this, but you know, I have to bring it up because that's what this whole series is about.
Is Fallout worth playing today?
Answer me this. Do you like survival games? Games that are purposefully brutal and indifferent to your suffering and struggles. Games where the game itself is designed to make interacting with it part of the difficulty? Do you like games where a lack of a narrative throughline allows you to superimpose your own story and motives onto characters? Can you deal with a user interface that's not just outdated, but was horrible for its time? If you answered yes to at least three of those, you might actually enjoy Fallout. For all its problems, it has a few solid things going for it, if you can put up with, or even enjoy, the rest. But if you didn't answer yes to at least three of those, then
you stay back! All of you, stay back! You stay the f*** back!
Age has not been kind to Fallout. Much like the old world within Fallout, the entire thing is crumbling, and it's better to dismantle the useful parts and use them to build something new. It no doubt introduced unmatched elements of role-playing and world-building to many players in its day, and admitting it plays like ass won't take away anyone's fond memories or how it influenced video games. But for everyone who wasn't playing it in 1997 and didn't have their minds blown because they could drop live dynamite in someone's pocket, well,
at the risk of getting swatted, you should probably skip this one. But, you know, maybe start with something like Fallout 3.